Hi everyone and thanks for watching. So this is already the fourth video in a row, so if you missed those other three parts and the introduction, go to the description down below and find those links. So basically again, it's all about having a good release first. So I like to use a wax first. I'll mostly do 4 coats and then just buff it off in between just to have a nice surface. After that, I like to use a trend spray. So it's a trend spray from Vossimi, and in the top right you can find a video where they show you how to make molds as well. So basically it's quite straightforward. You just spray it on. I mostly do 1 coat first, then buff it off a bit, and then add a 2nd coat after that. So after 4 coats of wax and 2 coats of spray release, you should be good to go. So up to the final is the reveal coat now. So this is a gel coat, it's quite easy to do, it's like just brushing on paint, and the mixture is the same as polyester resin. So for example, you make 200 grams of vinyl ester, then you just add 3 grams of MEC hardener. So if you make 200, you add 6 grams of MEC hardener. So after that you just mix it well, and then you just have to brush it on. So it's just like paint. You just brush it all around the parts and onto the parts. It's quite important to have a flange around the parts in case you want to do vacuum infusion and so on as well. So you just have to add 2 coats, wait 2 to 3 hours in between till it's in a tacky state, and then after that you can just add reinforcement. So I mostly like to use a 30 grams first, then build up some thickness with a 400 grams spiraglass, and to top it off I'll just use a 30 grams again just to have a nice finish on the outside. So this is how it should look like. The resin is brown first and then it'll just turn into a white state, and that's when the resin is cured. So after that you can just remove the structure that was built around the parts. By doing this you will expose the other side where we can add the 2nd part of the mold on. So a bit of force was used, but this is not because of the release agents, it's because of the modeling clay that was around the parts that was sticking onto the modeling board. So after that you can just trim off some excess. I did it with a scissor. And then again, it's just applying wax again, so just make sure you have enough wax and release agents to be able to have a good and easy release after that. So once again, just use a spray and then just buff it off in between. So up to vinyl ester again. So once again, you just paint it on, make sure everything is fully covered, and just add 2 coats again. So once that is done, I've tried a new technique. It's the tooling resin of Vossimi again with some cotton flakes into it just to make a thicker paste. So it's just like making a bondo out of polyester resin. So it will be less fluid and it will be easier to apply. And then on the undercuts, I just add some of these. So it should be in a caramel chocolate paste state, just to have a nice filling under the undercuts. So this is how it looked like. And then just after that, you can start adding some reinforcements. So once again, just cover the entire vinyl ester with some polyester tooling resin, build up some thickness. And this is an extra feature I added and wanted to show you guys. So this is an NFC tag. On the top right video, you can click on it and go to the example that I showed. And once again, this is how the molds look like now. Thanks for watching. You can check the other parts by clicking on the video on top of the screen. And in the next video, I'll show you how to prepare your molds for your first pre-prick parts. If you like what I'm doing and want to see some more, have a look at my Facebook page and give it a like. And if you really like my videos, please subscribe for more updates on my following projects. and don't forget to like or comment for some feedback or questions. So up to the next video, bye!